A state of emergency has been declared in northern Siberia. 21,000 tons of diesel spilled in an accident into the Amburnaya River near the city of Norilsk.
On the 29th of May, a fuel reservoir of a power plant in the Serbian city of Norilsk collapsed. Norilsk Nickel, the company which operated the power plant, claims the melting permafrost caused the accident. But early investigations tell a very different story. Built in 1985, the fuel tank required some major repairs since 2018. But the company continued to use it in breach of the safety rules, creating the largest environmental disaster to have hit the Arctic. The cleanup operation will take several years to complete.
Here, it is not possible to manage the situation in 5 minutes. In my opinion, we will still be removing fuel from the Amburnaya River for at least 8 to 10 days. At this time, a large quantity of fuel has arrived at our floating booms thanks to a south wind. Water with diesel has started to flow from all streams and bodies of water. Our cleaning conditions have become easier thanks to this.
Russian investigators have so far detained 3 staff members of Norilsk Nickel, including the manager of the power plant. Norilsk Nickel is the world's largest producer of platinum and nickel. The company is no stranger to environmental disasters. President Vladimir Putin pretended to be apologetic. He claimed he had learned of the accident from social media 2 days after the oil slick. Vladimir Putin has ordered for the company to pay $146 million for the cleanup of the Amburnaya River. But the environmental havoc wreaked by the oil spill far outweighs any financial penalty that can be imposed.
It is foolish to say or think that nothing will perish and that what happened will go away without a trace. Our workers saw dead donkeys. Today, I myself saw a dead muskrat. If a bird lands on fuel or if a muskrat swims in fuel, it is definitely condemned to death. But I cannot say that there is a mass extinction of animals. I have not seen it here.
The biggest challenge right now is to ensure that the oil spill does not spread into the nearby Lake Pyasino and the Kara Sea, part of the Arctic Ocean. Special containment booms have been installed. Dead fish, plumage of birds and animals poisoned due to the toxic sludge are already being found. About 340 tons of oil has been cleared in over 10 days of the cleanup operation. But it will be another 10 years before the Amburnaya River and the surrounding ecosystems would be able to recover and emerge from this disaster. Bureau Report, VON World is One.